हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रशांत त्यागी, लीगल इंटर्न फ्रॉम टीम लेक्सस एंड कंपनी। आई होप यू ऑल गाइस आर सेफ एंड हेल्दी। आई होप यू लाइक माय प्रीवियस वीडियो। प्लीज लाइक, शेयर, कमेंट ऑन माय वीडियोस एंड सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल लेक्स क्लिक फॉर गेटिंग लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक ऑफ कॉलेजियम सिस्टम। द टॉपिक दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन टुडेज एरा इज कॉलेजियम सिस्टम। इन दिस टॉपिक we will understand the introduction of the collegium system and the process and functioning of collegium system. The collegium system is refers to the appointment of judges, the functioning of judges, etc. So let's start our video. The judges of the Supreme Court are appointed by the President under Article 124, Subsection 2 of the Constitution of India, while judges of high courts are appointed by the president under Article 217(1) and 224(1) of Constitution. Judges of the Supreme Court and high courts are the appointed as per the procedure laid down in the memorandum of the procedure prepared in 1998 of the pursuant to the Supreme Court judgment of October 6, 1993. Read with the advisory opinion of October 28, 1998, the word collegium is never ever mentioned in the constitution. It has come into force at first judicial pronouncement. As per the memorandum of procedure, initiation of proposal for appointment of the judge in the Supreme Court vest with the Chief Justice of India, while initiation of the proposal of appointment of high courts vest with the Chief Minister of the concerned High Court. Chief Justice of the concerned High Court. Sometimes some of the names recommended by the High Court Collegium for the appointment as judges of High Courts are relatives of the sitting or retired judge of Supreme Court and High Courts. The government on its own cannot recommend any name for appointment as a judge of Supreme Court and High Court. However, if the Chief Minister desires to recommend the name of any person for the appointment as a judge of High Court, he she should forward the Chief Justice for his consideration. The name of the recommendees are considered by state constitution authorities. Supreme Court Collegium and constitutional authorities are the center before their appointment as judges of high courts. In the order to change the collegium system of appointments of the judges of the Supreme Court and High Court and to make it more broad-based and transparent, the government brought into force the Constitution 99th Amendment Act 2014 and National Judicial Appointment Commission Act 2014. However, both the acts were challenged in the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court wide judgment dated 16 October 2015 declares both the acts as unconstitutional and void. The collegium system as existing prior to the enforcement of the Constitution was declared to be operative. Subsequently, the Supreme Court wide order dated 16 December 2015 directed the government to finalize the existing MOP by supplementing in its consultation with the Supreme Court Collegium, taking into consideration eligibility criteria, transparency, establishment of secretariat and mechanism to deal with their complaints. As the process of finalizing the supplementation of existing MOP was likely to take some time at the initiative at the government. In the matter of continuing the appointment process was taken up the Supreme Court and appointment of judges of Supreme Courts and High Courts are being made as the existing MOP. The qualification of appointment of judges in the High Courts are provided in the Article 217, Subsection 2 of the Constitution of India. There is no examination either for advocates or judicial officers for appointment as judges in the High Courts. The appointments of judges in the High Courts are divided in the ratio of 2-1 between bar and judicial services. The advocates are considered for appointments as judges of High Courts based on their professional competence. Net average professional income was for last 5 years. Age reported judgment in each we has argued independently during last 5 years and other relevant factors. Now we discuss the process and functioning of collegium. Filling up of vacancies in the High Courts is a continuous and collaborative process of judiciary and executive involving various constitutional authorities. Hence, the precise time frame for filling up the post of judges of Supreme Court and High Courts cannot be indicated. No recommendations of the Supreme Court colleging for the year 2014 and is pending with the Government of India for the year 2015. The Supreme Court Collegium has conveyed on 1st August 2018 for remitting two names recommended by the High Court, Allahabad High Court, back to the Chief Justice of Allahabad High Court. The Collegium system of appointment of judges of the Supreme Court and High Court ceased to exist consequent upon the coming into force of the Constitution in the 1909 Amendment and the National Judicial Appointments Commission Act 2014. The constitutional validity of both the acts was challenged in the Supreme Court during the period when the relevant case was pending. Only those additional judges whose terms are expiring were given extension of service. The Supreme Court of India wide order dated 16 October 2015 struck down both the acts as constitutional and void, and the collegium system as existing prior to the enforcement of the both acts were declared to be operative. The Supreme Court India wide order dated 16 December 2015 regarding improvement of collegium system directed the government to finalize the existing memorandum procedure by supplementing it in consultation with the Supreme Court Collegium, taking into consider factors such as eligibility criteria, transparency, etc. At present, 143 names recommended by the High Court Collegium has been submitting and pending in Supreme Court Collegium. Further, 5 names recommended by Supreme Court Collegium have been referred back by the government to Supreme Court in the Collegium process and are under various consideration, and 27 proposals, including those names retired by Supreme Court Collegium, are various stages of proceeding with the government as per the procedure prescribed in the memorandum of process. I hope you understand this topic, collegium system, and you like this video. Please like, share, comment on my videos and subscribe our channel Lex Click for getting latest updates. Thank you so much. Stay safe, stay tuned, have a nice day.